I used to go and sit in front of Swami's photograph. And I used to tell, Swami, I want this. Believe me, whenever I wanted something, I prayed to Bhagavan with Om Sri Sai Ram, and miracles used to happen. While talking about me, I should tell you that I was a terrible child. A child, a restless, most naughty you can think of, uncontrollable, and this was my real nature. Mother used to say, whatever you want, you go and ask Swami. Ask Swami? How I'll ask Swami? He says, go and sit in front of Swami's photograph. Then what I should say? No, you should chant. What I should chant? He says, Om Sri Sai Ram. Okay. How many times I should chant? So, the more the better. So what she thought? 108 times, she said. 108 times? What is 108? I was too small to understand what is 108. Now here is a problem for her. Now how to teach this 108? So she thought, as you say Om Sri Sai Ram, please count your fingers in one hand and open it up once it over. This becomes 10. So each time when you do like this, keep on folding one finger on left hand. 10, then it'll become 20. Are you able to understand this? 50, and when you open it, it becomes 100 and another 8. This is 108. So whatever I ask, Swami will give? Definitely, she said. So whenever I wanted something, but you know what I did? I used to go and sit in front of Swami's photograph. And I used to tell, Swami, I want this. And how I used to do Om Sri Sai Ram? Om Sri Sai Ram, 10 times in this finger. Om Sri Sai Ram, 10 times this finger. And another 8. This 28 used to be my 108. But believe me, whenever I wanted something, I prayed to Bhagavan with Om Sri Sai Ram, and miracles used to happen. Not even once he ever failed me. All the time. Those were the good old days. Frequently, we used to go to Puttaparthi. And when we used to go to Puttaparthi, the only desire what we have, that Swami should call us for an interview. So the day I used to feel, Swami, today you should call us for an interview. 28 times Om Sri Sai Ram, definitely Swami used to call that day itself for an interview. This was going on and on, but my mischief and my restlessness never ever stopped. I was a hyper child. And those days, the Prashanthi Nilayam, it was not like this. There is no Sai Kulwand Hall. I still remember those beautiful days when you sit full of sand. The whole Prashanthi Nilayam, the front part used to be filled with sand. And those were the days, if you look the left side, there is nothing to block. East Prashanthi never, it was there. In fact, no buildings whatsoever, it was there. And you can see the Chitravati River directly flowing there. That is what I used to see. In fact, nowadays, of course, those were the days immediately after morning Nagar Sankirtanam. Nagar Sankirtanam used to stop where the present Ganesha temple is there. That Ganesha temple was not there. That came much later. So abruptly, we used to go and stop there and say, Om Shanti Shanti. Then everybody used to run inside. Why? By 6 o'clock, Swami used to come in the balcony. And Lord, someone used to come from the eastern side and directly used to fall on Swami's face, because he doesn't want to miss the Lord's darshan even one day. So he used to be there, and it was such a beautiful sight. And those days, when Swami used to come in the balcony, all the devotees used to stand up, and Swami used to give beautiful darshan. Oh, so why I am telling all these things was, though it was filled with sand, and sand and a mischievous child, combination, deadly combination. So, till Swami used to come out for darshan, I used to make castles, I used to throw sand here and there, And you know, those days the discipline was so strict in Prashanthinilayam, but I could care less. So this is how I used to play and disturbed everybody, all the devotees next to me. One of the devotees had its wits end. He shouted at me and said, "What a mischievous child you are. Can't you even sit quiet for 1 second? Swami is going to come out now and you are definitely going to get scoldings from Swami." I looked at him and said, "Me getting scolding? Swami won't scold me," I said to him. He said, "Definitely you are going to get scolding." "You want to see?" I asked him. "In fact, Swami will call me for an interview," I said. So this man, elderly man, he said, "For you, you will never get." "How can you say I won't get?" "That's all." I closed my eyes and 28 times Om Sri Sai Ram. And there comes Bhagavan. Bhagavan came and close to me, he looked at me and asked, "Where is your father?" he asked. I said, "Swami is sitting there in the back. Call him, go for an interview." And here was this man. Already his jaws are dropped, his eyeballs have almost out of its sockets. But I was not satisfied. I am keep looking at only him. And Swami standing in front of me. See my guts. I got up, stood like this in front of him, and went straight into the interview room. So, this is how Swami put the seed of Namaskmarana in my heart. Dear sisters and brothers, Swami proved to me from young age, the greatest thing in the whole world is God's name. And whatever you want to achieve in your life, taking that name, anything and everything you can have in your life, provided you take that name. It is very simple. In the Kali Yuga sadhana, there is no greater sadhana. In Krita Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, you had meditation, you had archana, all these various types of sadhanas were there. Whereas in Kali Yuga, it is the simplest. You don't have to even spend one pai. You can chant the beautiful name of the Lord and He will fulfill all our desires.